Well, when you have a chance to get out after many days of rain, you get out and see what you can find.
So I want to make this clear, guys. This was not a planned video for gaming or toy hunting, anything like that. I was out with the family. We were going to just get out and about and enjoy the day. And we just happened to be stopping by the Retro Madness over in the Arlington, Texas area. So I figured, hey, what the heck? I'm going to go through there and check it out. And I came across some of the Wii games, which the family enjoys doing on the weekend. We usually will play some Wii games together and have a little fun and compete and just a lot of laughs. So that was fun to look through those. Also, I want to get your opinion in the comments, guys. Let me know what are some good N64 titles to get. I didn't really play N64 a whole lot growing up, and I'm just starting to play it now. There's a few that I noticed that I even put in the video, as you can see, that I was pretty curious about. But let me know in the comments what are some good titles that you can suggest that I can give a try. Also, really enjoy seeing these Kirby plushes, and any plushes that have to do with gaming or retro stuff is really cool, and I'm always intrigued. But I can say I have been growing my PS2 game collection, and they had some pretty good titles here that I was looking through, and a lot of them I had, but I'm always curious with PS2 because that's one of the consoles I am collecting for, but I always collect the games that I know and have played before anything else. And it was really cool as well to see the PlayStation kiosk set up in store. I took an opportunity to look at that. But also let me know, guys, what you think about the movies that came out for the PSP. I never even bought any, but I do have a PSP, so are they worth buying or no? Even checking out the game magazine selection they have, everything from Nintendo Power to Game Informer and strategy guides. Really cool to see if there's particular games you're just wanting to play and go back and play and just learn a little bit more of the secrets and what have you. That's always cool to see. The only one that really caught my attention besides Nintendo Power was the Guitar Hero 2 game, because we play that quite often. So that might have been a good pickup as well. I considered getting that, but I wasn't real sure. But I had to make sure before I left the store that I checked out the Transformers display. They had a big display and a bunch of available for sale. I'm always trying to collect the G1 Transformers for my collection, and they had a good selection, so I was pretty impressed. The Ghostbuster toys, I still don't have any of those, really. I have the Ecto-1, so that's a cool one that I have, at least that. The Sonic the Hedgehog in this box was pretty interesting. This Batman, I had to get on film because that was probably from like the 60s. But the main thing that I look for when I go into any gaming store is NES games, because I enjoy the NES. The NES was my first console to own, and I always go through and see what they have. So after leaving, I ended up settling on the Untouchables. Never played it. Seen the movie multiple times. It seems like a good game. I'm going to give it a shot. The Untouchables, why not? So afterwards, stopped by the GameStop over in that area of Arlington and went through some of the Switch games that they had. Kind of went through the new and the pre-owned. They had a good deal going on, so I figured, hey, let's see what they got. Pick up something or two and just kind of go from there. Did come across the Supermarket Shriek. I don't know if anyone's ever played this or heard of it. They only had one in store and one in copy, and apparently none of the other stores had it, so I considered this one. It was cool to see as well the SpongeBob display and the Bebop and Krang statues from the Ninja Turtles. The Funko Pop stuff you kind of see everywhere, and it's cool to see. Also enjoyed seeing that Grimlock. That was really cool to see. They had some good selection of stuff that you could put on your mantles or what have you in your gaming area, or just your add to your collection. So I just wanted to make sure I got some of that on film. Ended up stopping in at the Think Geek, which was not far from the GameStop. So I checked it out. Came across the Richard Simmons plush. Considered getting that because grew up watching Richard Simmons in the 80s. That was pretty cool to see. So I thought that was a good lot of laughs. And I really enjoyed watching on the wall that they had a lot of stuff on sale, which was a lot of stuff that was stuff from the 80s and 90s. It was the Turtles and the Transformers. I mean, you name it, they had it. And I was really eager to just grab some of that stuff. And as I made our way out, came across all the Super Mario stuff, from figurines into gaming set statues and stuff and that you could put together. And it was just cool to see some of the stuff. They had some really good things to get. I didn't really grab any of them, but I almost did buy the Link action figure set. That was a really cool setup. I like that. I might go back and get that. But other than that, guys, that was our trip. That was our day out. This was not planned at all. We just had an opportunity to get out after all the rain, and we had a lot of fun. Ended up picking up The Untouchables, like I said, for the NES. This is going to be fun. I actually looked up to see what it looked like. I'm ready to play this. And Supermarket Shriek, I ended up taking it. It looks fun. It looks interesting. And something about a screaming goat makes me laugh. So again, thanks for taking the time, guys, to watch. I hope you enjoyed. Like, share, subscribe. Later.